for some reason, one of the last things I ever think of is that Christ is up there because he wanted to be. Jesus Christ is on that cross because he wanted to be. And I think, at least in terms of me, I think of other things. He did that for my salvation, or his death causes us to have eternal life, allows us to have the opportunity for eternal life. But I don't think often enough he's there because he willingly wanted to be. He did not have to be. Jesus Christ was not overpowered by his enemies and forced to be on that cross. I think many of you know that in the gospel, many, many times, the Pharisees back him into a corner and they try to stone him to death. And Christ kind of just disappears. Get out of here, guys. He just walks away. Another time, remember, they force him to the brink of a cliff. And it's like he disappears. And he walks right through them. Many, many times in the gospel, there's many instances in which the enemies of Jesus try to apprehend him and put him to death, but they're powerless to do so. Because as the Lord explained several times in the gospels, my hour has not yet come. Well, in today's gospel, the appointed time has drawn near. And Jesus knew of his approaching death, and he willingly accepted that death as part of God's plan so that we could have eternal life. And I have found in my case, and maybe you can as well, that on Good Friday, if you look at a crucifix, let us realize that Jesus Christ is there because he wants to be. He died because he wanted to do so as part of God's plan and for our salvation. It was then the perfect expression of his free personal love for God the Father and for all of you. Okay, let's stand.